the end of the interview. And you also might have heard her track Do It Like a Dude. It's in the charts right now. It's doing big things. This girl is going to be massive, originally from Essex. Here is here's what happened when I caught up with Jessie J.
You're now tuned in to DJ Kayper.
DJ Kayper.
Yeah.
How you doing, Jessie J?
Welcome. I'm good. Thank you.
It's good to have you on because I'm a massive fan.
Ah.
I've been following you on YouTube for a while.
Like a stalker.
Like a stan. Like a proper stan. That is what I am. I find it amazing. You're only 22, right?
Yeah.
And it feels like you've done so much already.
I'm 22. I'm like, oh gosh, yeah, I am.
Well, you started out, you went to the Brits, right?
Yeah. I went to the Brit School when I was 16.
I've always wondered, right, because I live near the Brit School, and for some reason I've never seen anyone go in there or come out of there.
It is a bit weird, isn't it? It's round the back, so it's like...
Do people actually really go to the Brit School? And then you hear about...
It's an illusion. It's like, yeah, it's like the dance school version of the Illuminati.
Exactly.
There's only a few of us.
Yeah, and you've had, like, I think Adele went to the Brits.
Yeah, Adele, Rox.
KEB,
Amy.
Yeah.
Yeah, there's a few of us.
When you went to the Brit School, did you actually live in Croydon?
No, I didn't. I commuted every day, which meant I was up at 5 a.m, 4 a.m, most mornings for 2 years, and did 6 trains there and back. Had no friends. Didn't have a social life, but, you know, I got four A's.
It must be hard work to go to a performing arts school and to have to do the normal subjects, which you obviously...
Oh, I didn't do that. I just went and did my A-levels there. When you're...
Oh, really?
Yeah, when I was 16 to 18, I just did musical theatre. So I did drama, singing and acting, and then I did a fine art course as well. But you can go to the Brit School when you're, like, 14 and do year 10 and 11. I couldn't do that personally.
Right.
It was a bit too much, like, fame. For me, you know, and it's like you do your science and then you go into the cafeteria and everyone's like doing a 7-part harmony of Oh Happy Day.
Yeah,
it just would have thrown me off a bit, I think.
What happened to the girl group that you used to be in?
Soul Deep. I was in a girl group, yeah, for a couple of years, and I loved working with them girls. We still keep in contact now, and we did an anti-gun campaign together called Mothers Against Guns, and that was something that was really important to me, and I think that's kind of what sparked my career to write music that kind of helps people. I don't just wanted to kind of write songs that just throw away. It was kind of that thing of, wow, actually my music's moving people and helping people, and I think that's what sparked that inside me to write music like that. So I think that's where the journey really began for me to take my music seriously.
Yeah.
And being in a girl group's always fun because it's the fun stuff, but you kind of get to learn your craft with 3 other people kind of being looked at as well, so it's not all about you. But yeah, I really enjoyed it.
Mm-hmm. I only found this out a little while ago, right? You wrote Party in the USA.
It's Party in the USA.
I did.
And do you know what? After I found that out, it all kind of made sense, because when I heard that track, I always wondered, like, I wonder what Jay-Z thinks of Miley Cyrus mentioning his name in her track.
Yeah, I remember writing it with Luke and Claude. It was kind of just as I'd got signed to Republic in the US, and it was really early on in kind of discovering and learning and growing up and of redeveloping myself as a songwriter and really kind of taking risks and just finding a new sound that suited me. And it was really early on, and it was a great pop song and the label loved it, but I don't think it was edgy enough for me.
Right.
And it's actually quite a parody. If you heard my version, it's like almost me taking the mic, and I think I would have, if I'd have done it and done a video, it would have just been exactly what the lyrics were.
So was she pretty shocked when it went to number one then?
I didn't believe it. Luke texted me and I had jet lag, and I woke up and I was like, I read my phone and he was like, it's gone to number one on iTunes. I was like, ah, joker, and put my phone down.
Yeah.
And then my phone started ringing and I was like, and he phoned me, he was like, it's gone to number one, seriously? And I was like, oh, pressure. Like, one of the first songs I gave away went to number one in 6 countries. Like, what do I do now? Do you know what I mean? I need to write another happy birthday or something like that.
I hopped off the plane at LAX with a dream, my cardigan. Welcome to the land of fame, excess. Am I gonna fit in? Jumped in the cab, here I am for the first time. Look to my right and I see the Hollywood sign. This is all so crazy. Everybody seems so famous. My tummy's turning and I'm feeling kinda homesick. Too much pressure and I'm nervous. That's when the taxi man turned on the radio. And the Jay-Z song was on. And the Jay-Z song was on. And the Jay-Z song was on. So I put my hands up to play my song. The butterflies
Asia Network. I'm sorry, I have to admit this to you, that when, like, because I DJ in the States quite a bit, and when that track came out, I got asked for it so many times, I just wanted
to... Oh, no, you hate it.
I just wanted to strangle.
Do you know what? It's fine. I'm sure all the mums and dads around the world are disliking me right now. Yeah. But the kids love me.
The kids love you. The funny thing is as well as building your career here in the UK, I know you're kind of simultaneously doing it in the US. Do you feel like you have to be two different people?
I did in the beginning, I won't even lie to you. It was really hard to get the balance right, but I think the more I go on and the more that's online, because online isn't, you know, it's not restricted to one country, there's no limits. So it's like everyone around the world can get what everyone gets once it goes online. And realistically, right now, the only thing the UK has is gigs and radio over the US. And for me, like, Do It Like A Do reaction in the US has been amazing. And I think it's, to be honest, it's great to have the opportunity to have like two different songs out at the same time across the world, to kind of go, I do different genres, like Who You Are and Do It Like A Do are two totally different sounding songs, but I'm the same person. Like, Do It Like A Do is just a part of me that's very fun, and you know, it very much exists. And it's funny because people think I'm being serious, but I'm actually, that video to me is like a parody. It's my take on all these guys that feel like they have to talk about, you know, how many girls they've got and how much money they have, and I'm this and I'm that, and all of us girls have seen it, you know what I mean, and it's frustrating. And it's like the same for guys have, you know, girls that overpower them in their lives. And I think it's one of those great songs that you just have a bit of fun with. It's not supposed to be a massive song like to sing, whereas Who You Are is more the kind of raw me that's kind of very open. And And it's nice to be able to showcase those two things and not have to go, right, this is your genre. The album has to sound like a version of the single 12 times. You know what I mean? So it's nice. It's nice to be able to take risks.
I've got to say, though, your performance on Jules Holland was...
terrible.
Yeah, it was rubbish. No, it was amazing.
Thank you.
Like, after I saw you on Jules Holland, I was like, oh, my God.
It was really nice for me to have the video come out and Jules Holland on the same day.
Yeah.
Because I want people to know that, you know, I'm 22, as I said, I'm fun, and the video's fun. It's not serious. I'm not trying to be some man-eating, crazy, crystal-lip-wearing freak.
Yeah.
I'm just having fun, and Price Tag's obviously a very... It was a stripped-down performance, which is really nice to do it just acoustic.
Yeah.
And to be on Jules Holland, that's a really credible thing to do as an artist. It was a great balance, do you know what I mean? And it's like being part of history when you go on something like Jules Holland. And
that is brilliant. When is the album out? Next year?
It's in discussion right now.
Okay.
I think we're just kind of looking at how things are going.
Have you finished the album?
I don't think I'll ever finish it. I'll always be adding to it, I think.
I think I heard you say in another interview that it's taken you 5 years to write the
album. That's the thing. I mean, I started Big White Room, Stand Up, Mama Knows Best, and a couple of the other tracks I wrote 5 years ago.
Mm-hmm.
And they're still with me now. And it's like you kind of go around half the world trying to find a sound, and you come back to the songs that you wrote at the beginning. So, yeah, you kind of get... I always say you get 5 years to write the first one and 2 weeks to write the second one. And I'm already started writing the second one, what I think, you know, what people will want, just from based on the reaction of what people want now.
Right.
And I don't know, I'm just rolling with punches. I'm just going to see how it goes. And
brilliant. Do you know what? I can't let you come on the show and not show people how well you can sing. Because for anyone that doesn't know, anyone that listens to the BBC Asian Network and may not have heard your music, I think this...
Do you know the crazy thing, right? This might not be interesting to you at all, but I've got videos of me singing in Gujarati when I was like 3.
Why?
Because I grew up with a Hindu family, and my best friend when I was a kid, I literally grew up with her, and so like... It's fun.
That's
cool.
Hilarious.
It's nice to be on Asian Network.
I'm actually quite shocked at what you just said.
I'll get the video out and I'll send it to you just to prove it. And I'm like 3 years old.
Oh my
Juma,
God.
Juma, de, de. Is that a song?
It is. I don't know what. I'm rubbish.
Jeez, about it. How does it go? Juma.